coming in there now. They're buying it because it's so much more comfortable for them. They look so much better. They're held together better, properly, and they start looking very fashionable about being a nurse. You know, so they just worried about being looking too sexy. You know,
this is the technological age, and I'm sure you must have employed a tremendous amount of technology, the expertise at getting these outfits or these pants to fit the way they do. This is not simply cutting some material. This has a whole, I'm sure a whole lot of research went into this, eh?
Well, they all know how much attention I pay to details. I mean, they know that, I mean, they're looking at every little detail, you know, every little stitch. You know, this has to be adjusted a little bit. I must have done this pattern about 1,000 times, you know, before it's perfect for me, you know. And then nobody else has been able to duplicate. I actually patent the pattern that I made. It is technological. This, the basic block that you make is really technical. You know, the issue, the fashion in the first instance has to fit. And the second instance has to feel good. And then third, it has to make you feel young. But it starts in those kind of orders. And as soon as a customer puts his garments on, they 90% of the time leave that changing room and say they're not happy. What a frustrating feeling that must be. Somebody takes all their clothes off, wants to buy this garment, puts it on, and so disappointed that they don't want to buy it after. We don't disappoint them. Mm-hmm. We don't disappoint them. They put it on. It's only a matter of which waistband you might like, you know, mm-hmm. or which leg you might like. And then it's a matter of selling more and more of them. But mm-hmm. to your point, it is very technological business and a very much meticulous attention to detail. You know, Steve Jobs was doing this particular attention to detail on his iPhone. Mm-hmm. When I've been doing meticulous attention very well, same here over here. And I always have a next product coming up, like Steve Jobs did.
Yes.
But it is a meticulous business, and they all know how meticulous I am. I mean, down to the last minute.
A quality control is extremely important in the manufacturing of these, I'm sure, because you have various materials. I see that you use, this is leather. You have some other materials for slims. How do you deal with the quality control issues?
We have a huge network behind the scenes. So we have a very big operation in China. We have a whole QC team. There's about maybe 200 of them in there who are also in their factories already looking at the quality control in production. We already saw a huge QC team looking at the fabric places where they're actually producing the fabric and make sure they're testing it properly. It has proper weight to it, proper shrinkage to it, proper pilling qualities. That QC behind the scenes is everything. And my infrastructure is best there is. We've been known all our life for quality. Mm-hmm. We've been known all our life for fit, you know, and we never betray the customer in those two girls. That's a sacred call with us.
And all of the pants that you now have are NIGAD Slims, eh?
Yeah, you don't want to know how many I have in my closet. I've been collecting since 2013.
Okay.
And many women will find that, of course, once you determine the waistband that you're interested in, then you can build your wardrobe based on different silhouettes and different functionalities. I think the thing that Slims also offers is that it's day to night, it's office to night. You know, you're able to have different functions with the fashionability as well. Mm-hmm. So,
I am looking forward to Saturday and what you're going to offer, and I'm sure you're going to have some people now are modeling these outfits, but knowing Peter NIGAD, it's going to be a nice party too at the mall at Marathon. Eh?
You bet. Lots of energy. There'll be so far 130 looks. Beautiful women being able to show the fashions, the different sizes, different heights, and everyone will be able to find a pair. We'll have stylists on hand to be able to suit you up and get you in a pair of slims for all the women that come out and join us at Marathon Mall.
You're going to have two shows?
3 p.m. and 6 p.m.
3 p.m. and 6 p.m.
Yes.
Very good. Well, I'm going to try to make the 6 p.m. one, just to see. I can't, you know, you're not designing anything for men right now, so we are only looking on, eh?
We actually, I am now working on men. So these are my own men ones I'm wearing.
Okay.
So I'm testing them out, and I'll tell you a funny story. These slims are so tight that fit you so well, and I always test our own fabrics. So I went to bed in one of the women's slims, and it was really quite crowded. You see, there was no room for us manliness. I woke up in the morning, wanted to buy a pair of ballet shoes. I started kicking my leg like the best.
You wanted the ballet shoes to match your pants?
Yeah, when I sort of changed my gender, I said, great, let me get this off. In other words, they really are tight and they squeezed me.
I understand.
Yeah, so it was a bit of a joke, but the issue is works so well. And now there's been a call for many places for doing it for men. I use these own fabrics. I've been wearing them myself now all the time. I test all our own fabrics. Okay. You know, all our own fabrics.
Okay.
And I do have men's. Now, I would like to have you test them, the women's one, the way I did. And go to bed with them.
See
the same reaction.
Well, Brittany, thank you so very much for being here today. And we look forward to seeing you on Saturday at the Grand Fashion Show that you are going to be participating in. Not as a model. She is the marketing coordinator for Nygaard Slims. When we return, we're going to have another kind of conversation with Peter Nygaard, because he's involved in so many things, including stem cell research. We take this break and we'll come right back.